What is bounded context? Bounded context is a central term in domain-driven design. It is considered a strategic design pattern to deal with large domain models and systems. What is domain-driven design? Domain-driven design is about finding one and only one language that developers and business domain experts can use to communicate with each other so that there are no communication problems. Domain-driven design is about discovering the model in a particular domain. For example, you may be working for a finance company, and finance company may have some products, it may have customers. So domain-driven design is about finding these models so that it can help. Not only it helps you to collect the requirements about the domain from the domain experts, it also helps you to design your components, classes. Domain-driven design act as a conceptual foundation for designing your software, how to design your component, classes, or functions. Before I go deep into what is bounded context is, let me give you some example from the software world. If you come from C# or Java, in Java you have packages, in C# we have namespaces. Why we need namespaces in C# or packages in Java? These are logical containers to package our classes. For example, we may be working for shipping department. In shipping namespace, you may have customer. The shipping namespace is only interested finding out the address of the customer so that it can ship the product. Whereas there could be another namespace or package called billing. Billing namespace will be more interested in finding about the credit card details so it can send a bill or invoice to the customers. So we can see how packages or namespace act as a container or logical groupings for the classes. Same is true about bounded context. The good domain-driven design is making sure that there is a consistency, unification of the models in the domain. In shipping, there can be only one customer. There should not be any ambiguity about that. But as we started discovering model over the big enterprise level, it becomes a lot more difficult because as we saw, the customer means different in shipping department, customer means different in billing department. There are different vocabularies are used in different departments, and some of the big enterprise, they may have offices across different geographical locations. They may have office in India, they may have office in USA. A lot of time their vocabularies would be different. So it's very, very difficult to come up a unified dictionary, unified model for enterprise level. Let me give you example. Suppose a enterprise has office in India and office in USA. In India, we call it billing, whereas in USA, you call it invoice. And again, for mobile phone, in USA, it's called mobile. In India, we call it cellular. And for address, we use term zip code in America, whereas India, it's called postal code. So we can see how difficult it is to come up with one vocabulary. If we ask people in India to use American vocabulary, there may be resistance from the America. There may be resistance from Indian employees. And if you tell American employees to use Indian terms, there would be resistance from America. So bounded context solve these problems by creating subdomains. Whereas in Indian subdomain, you may use the terms billing, cellular phone, postal code, whereas American domain, you would use the American terms. And they, some of the models, some of the concepts could be interrelated and some could be independent. So what are the benefits of dividing models into sub-domain models using bounded context concept so that these models can develop, grow independently without tying down by a unified model? So thank you very much, friends, for watching this video. If you like this video, like it, share it, and subscribe to my channel for your regular updates. Also, connect with me on LinkedIn and Twitter, especially LinkedIn if you like small summaries of the video. I will be posting a lot of small summaries of the video on LinkedIn. Thanks again.